Hey friends, it's Etherealite coming to you today from my bedroom, and I'm extremely sunburnt. We just tore up the old garden that was here in this house we moved into, and we're gonna try to grow some fruits and veggies this year, so I'm feeling really hot right now. Today's video is gonna be about shadow work and how to tell if you are avoiding observing certain emotions that need to be observed and noticed inside of your beingness. So I'm an expert at this. Hello, my name's Etheria. I'm a chronic avoider of anything uncomfortable, but we're working on that, all right? So I think a lot of us, sensitive empaths, light workers, star seeds, we're just wired differently than other people. We feel things so deeply. We're sensitive, we're psychic, we're in touch, we're in tune. But along with that is a lot of us, like I've mentioned in some of my other videos, are a lot more crutchier, have a lot more tendency towards having crutches and addictions than just the average person who may not be feeling in any now moment how intensely we're feeling something. Like, even just for example, like me and my fiance will watch a movie and he'll be like, calm down, because I get so into it. I'm like, oh, I can't believe you did that. Horrible. Like, I feel like it's not real. But in the moment, it's freaking real. So don't tell me it's not fucking real. It's real to me. Anyways, so I have my little notes laid out in front of me. Bear with me. I'm going to eventually get a whiteboard or something, chalkboard, so that I can put my notes up behind me and give you guys sort of a visual as I'm going through my videos. So bear with me as I'm looking down to kind of keep myself in order. But here are some telltale signs that you have some shadow aspects inside of yourself that you have been avoiding. It doesn't always look like drugs and alcohol or smoking as a means and an addiction or a crutch in order to not feel pain. There's a lot of things we do. We emotionally eat. Vegging out, that's a huge one, especially in this day and age with Facebook and smartphones. Just try it on yourself. Try to go and sit down on your couch or in your room without music, without the TV on, with no sound, no one around, not getting on your phone, not eating or drinking, and just sitting there with yourself. You're going to start being like, oh my God. All this uncomfortable emotion starts arising in you. And so what do? We're like, distract, TV, phone, sex, drugs, food. I don't want to feel this. It's a lot. And you shouldn't shame yourself in it, and I'll go into why your ego is doing that later on, but, you know, that's another crutch and addiction we have in order to not feel and notice and observe these emotions that are inside of us. A huge one that, hello again, I'm guilty of is spiritual bypassing. So that can look like, you know, instead of doing your shadow work, you're just watching videos all day on spirituality and aliens and ascension and 3D to 5D and emerald tablets and what have you, instead of doing your own shadow work. Hello, I did that for like 2 years. I still do that. I'm like, that's uncomfortable. Let's watch this. But girl, boy, you gotta feel it. We gotta deal with it, okay? So I'm gonna give you some tips that has helped me and helped me to understand all of this ambiguous, esoteric way of handling things, I guess. Because a lot of times, you know, you'll watch a video and someone will sound so intelligent and the way they say something sounds so smart, but you can't quite grasp it. And then one day, eventually, you hear it so much, you're like, oh my God, that's what they mean. So this shadow work being explained this way to me is how it finally clicked for me after a long time. So I'm gonna try to explain it how it helped me to help you guys, okay? I'm just here to help, doing my best, okay? I'm not an expert. So like I said earlier, your ego is just trying to survive. So it's natural for you to run away from those uncomfortable emotions, to sit there and be like, okay, this is really uncomfortable. I need my phone, I need drugs, I need alcohol, I need to smoke, I want a cheesecake. But it's natural because your ego is serving you the best way it can, in that it's trying to keep you alive and healthy. And it doesn't know the difference between you being fearful for remembering a traumatic event that happened when you were 8 years old, Or if you're fearful because there's a tiger in front of you and it's gonna fucking eat your brain. So literally, your ego's just doing the best it can. The ego gets a lot of flack, but it's just trying to help you survive, okay? And it's necessary on a, to a certain extent to be living down here in Gaia right now, on Gaia. So emotions, at the end of the day, they just want to be observed. They just want to be felt. But you want to observe them without identifying with them. And that learning this was like, because my entire life, I've felt things extremely deeply, like I'm sure a lot of you are. Got diagnosed as depression, anxiety, ADD from the time I was 13 on up. And it's when I really just sat there and said, wow, you know, I am depressed, I am anxious, that my life spiraled out of control. And I went on medication for years, years and years and years and years and years. And I still take some. I don't take it every day, but I will admit that that's the last crutch I have to work through. And I was the kid who was on three or four different medications. Well, not at a time, probably two. But because my parents couldn't get me out of bed morning, I always knew school was fucking bullshit. I didn't fit in. I was weird. My friends were fucking mean to me. I attracted narcissistic, abusive ass boyfriends from the time I was 15 and started dating. And it spiraled me down a really dark, almost 10 years. So I was also in high school 10 years ago when the whole emo goth thing was popular. And that was kind of my style because that was my scene. I felt as if I was understood because here was this whole, you know, sort of culture around, yeah, I feel fucking pain. I'm sad. I'm depressed. I don't want to get out of bed. I have suicidal thoughts. And my sisters were cheerleaders and prom queens and stuff. And I was the artsy, like, guitar, emo skater girl, whatever. But I identified with those kids because, and the music and just the culture because I felt fucking pain. But what ended up happening is the more I identified with that pain, the more I became it and the more it ate me and consumed me. When in reality, if I were to just observe what was going on and observe the emotions I was feeling and not say I'm depressed, say I'm not, no, I'm not depressed, but I'm observing some sadness right now. I'm observing some pain. I'm observing some loneliness. I'm observing some not fitting in and just sort of look at it from an outside perspective instead of saying this is me and what's wrong with me and why am I this way and why aren't my sisters this way and why don't my parents understand me and why do I have to go on medication? And when we don't, when we get older and we find these coping mechanisms, like I said, whether it's drugs, alcohol, partying, smoking weed, smoking cigarettes, emotionally eating disorders, looking through our phone all day, watching TV, when we don't observe these emotions, they can manifest as, you know, disease, illness, fatigue, chronic fatigue. Hello, struggled with that for a long time. Inability to fall asleep and stay asleep because these emotions want to be observed, and you're like, nope, I'm not. I'd rather take a Tylenol PM until my eyes close. But skin issues is another one I know I said, but hello. Like I said, hello, this is me. Not being judgmental because this is literally me on paper trying to help you guys because I know you guys are like me and I love you. I fucking love you guys. Let me just say that. I relate to you guys more than I relate to my own family and friends, okay? Because you guys, we understand each other. But like I said, observe, don't identify with it. And if you feel something coming up, and let's say like you're at the mall or you're at your mom's house, and then all of a sudden you feel this uncomfortable, like, depression, sadness, darkness, anxiety coming over you. That might not be the best time to sit there and observe it, but that doesn't mean you just completely shove it back down, because these emotions never go away until they are observed. So you could have emotions inside of you from you were 8 years old that you've been eating and drinking and smoking every time it comes up, having sex with everyone, just like, oh, I don't want to fucking feel this, pushing it down. Hello again. But they have to be felt at the end of the day. And it doesn't have to be as scary as you think. Because like I said, you have to identify. It doesn't have to become you, like, oh, I'm depressed, I'm anxious, I'm having this. Just, I'm observing this. This is uncomfortable. But like I said, like going back to what I was saying, you might have to set aside time. So tell yourself, and it sounds corny, but really there's a part of you that you've been betraying, probably unknowingly, since that part of you was little, saying, okay, you know, I'm not going to sit there with that emotion. I don't want to feel that, but I'll push it down. So just like a parent does that to their child, you're fine, get up, you're not hurt, you know, tough it up, blah, blah, blah. You might mean it in a nice way, but to that child, it's still traumatic. And you're doing that to your own inner child, to your own self, when you're saying, you're fine, drink, drug, alcohol. You're telling yourself that you are not worthy of being heard and being felt and understood and observed and brought into the light, which is what we are doing with our shadows. We're bringing light to them, illuminating them. So if you're at your mom's house or you're at a party or something and you feel it coming up, but you're like, crap, you know, it's not ideal to sit here and journal or cry or feel this pain right now around all these people or at this time and place, then just tell yourself, okay, you know, tonight at 9 p.m. when I get home, me and you, it's on. And I'm going to sit with this emotion. And, but do that, you know, don't tell yourself you're going to do that and then not, because you're just betraying yourself even more. And something that I really like to do, I know I've said this in a few of my videos, is journaling. I've always been really good with writing. As you can tell, sometimes I talk, I come across as a little ADD, ADHD, which I don't really believe in that. I believe a lot of us star seeds are diagnosed with that because they don't understand the way we think. And we were meant to come here and sit still for 8 hours a day and go to work and go to school and do shit we hate. We weren't wired that way. And so they're like, oh, ADD, ADHD, anxiety. So like I was saying, going off on my tangents, but journaling, I can sit there and I can get the emotions out and I can feel them. And it's a release. And writing music, poetry, you know, find an outlet, but get that emotion out, express it. If you are, you know, good with just words, you can try talking to someone about it, someone you trust. I would suggest somebody more on this similar path, because they're going to understand more, like shadow work. When you're doing, you want to feel pain. Other people are going to bite that. They're like, wait, you want to feel pain? You want to sit there and feel your pain? That's weird. Don't do that. But someone who can be like, yeah, that's great. Let's do this. You know, I've got you. Reach out to me if you want, you know, comment down below if you ever need someone to just talk to. I'm here. I believe that all the things I've been through in my life has been so I can help you guys, you know, make it a little easier for you. So, like I said, wait till later if needed, but make sure whenever you tell yourself you're going to sit with those feelings that you actually do. And then also notice the triggers and what it's disguised as. So this is something I actually just realized, like during the whole COVID pandemic, because let's be honest, it's nothing. So, but when it came up, I noticed fear inside of myself coming up. So I was like, why am I fearing this? This isn't anything to fear. This was created by man. Why am I feeling this fear? But I've realized that a lot of my traumas and shadow work that come up are triggered. They're triggered when I'm at any soul. I've always had like slight social anxiety because, like many of you, you're an empath. You can literally feel and hear everyone, what they're thinking without them saying it. And you're picking up on all their energies and you're like, oh my God, it's a lot. So I've gotten better with age, but like if I go to Walmart, which I shop there, I know it's a not the greatest store, but it's cheap and I got two kids and I'm young, so leave me alone. So, but I will literally come out of there and I'm always like, I feel the pain, I feel the trauma coming up, but it disguises itself to me as health anxiety. So I'll be like, that's a weird pain in my arm. Well, every time, like, and it's weird because for years I did this my whole life and I just now realized what it was. But like, I've always, like, if I have a weird pain, weird ache, I like Google it, which do not freaking do that. I'm a slight hypochondriac, but I'll be like, oh my God, I have stage four terminal cancer. This is horrible. I have leukemia, AIDS, and everything. And that's just like on the way home from Walmart to my house. I diagnosed myself with all of this. I'm like, I'm dying. Goodbye. It was nice to see you and nice to know you guys. But it's when I'm in a crowded area, especially among strangers in low vibration places like Walmart. Like, that's not exactly where, not to be judgmental, but that's not exactly where the highest vibe people tend to hang out. But yeah, so one suggestion I have, if you've ever heard of Victor Odo, he's an amazing YouTuber, and I always resonate with him and his story. And he said that he'll shop with headphones in and listen to like rock and roll music, and it kind of blocks out some of those vibrations. So that's something I do. I'll listen to music, listen to podcasts, kind of tune the world out. But like I said, so notice your triggers. Notice, okay, how come every time I'm leaving my mom's, I suddenly have a fear that I'm dying, or I suddenly worry about my relationship? It can literally be anything that is triggering it. It can be people. Maybe you have a certain friend, and every time they leave, you're like, wow, I feel fucking horrible about myself. What are they triggering inside of you? What are they triggering to bring to the surface for you? And it's not always like I used to think, well, you're triggering me. How dare you trigger me? Something's wrong with you. But it's a service in a way. Maybe they agree. Maybe you have a soul contract before you came to this earth, which I believe a lot of us do with the people in our life, saying, I'm going to trigger you. I'm going to be a narcissistic, abusive boyfriend to you to get you to stand in your personal power and realize how much of a badass you are and stand up for yourself and go through drug addiction, alcohol addiction, self-harm, sexual abuse, physical abuse, mental abuse. Just all the things. It's like five of the many things that have happened to me in my life, which I know a lot of you have been through the same. So, you know, notice what those triggers are and then notice how it manifests. And I think a lot of people actually, it does manifest as health anxiety. So if you're someone who is all of a sudden sitting there freaking out, you're like, my heart's beating really fast. This is it. I'm having a heart attack. And it's really anxiety. Guilty. Then, you know, sit there and try to correlate, you know, maybe jot down when it's happening. Okay, this is what I was just doing. This is what I was just eating. This is who I was just around. And then over time, you know, compare notes and see if there's any correlation between what you're doing, who you're around, and how you're feeling as these shadows arise. So the last thing is to just show utter self-compassion and love for yourself. And like I said, it sounds corny, but it is so good to do. Put your hands on your heart space when you finally are sitting there and you're gonna observe the emotions. So sit there and just go and show and feel the love you have for yourself. And like I said, this sounds really hippie, esoteric, but we're hippie and esoteric on this channel, okay? And this is how we heal, guys, to be serious. But put your hands on your heart space and really just feel the compassion you have for that part of you that is hurting, for that part of you that has made you a drug addict for 15 years, for that part of you that has made you hate yourself for your entire life because you've never been okay with what's happened to you. You've never shined light on that's happened to you, that has wanted so badly for you just to see it and acknowledge it. And just, you know, say, I understand. Like, you know, if it's coming up as whatever, I understand. I'm sorry you're going through that. Tell that to yourself. I'm sorry you're going through that. I love you. I love you so much. You are amazing. You got this. I love you. It's going to be okay. And just sit there and don't try to push it away. Sit there as long as it needs. And before you reach for your crutch, so before you go and text somebody, before you get a booty call, before you have your husband and you have sex, before you go and eat something, go before you do drugs or smoke or whatever, just try to sit there as long as you can with that emotion, that uncomfortability. Make it just even 5 or 10 minutes at first. And then when you do decide, okay, I'm going to reach for that crutch now, love that part of you also. And that is key, because so much of our addictions and crutches, we hate ourselves because we have them. And we hate the part of ourselves that's just trying to survive. And in turn, we become more engrossed and hell-bent on these fucking addictions and crutches because we hate the very part of us that is just trying to get by. And there's such a, the way society treats addicts in general, and it's just, it's trauma that hasn't been dealt with. And they need to show themselves compassion, because the more you say, God, I hate myself, I'm gonna go smoke a fucking cigarette now, oh, I'm so disgusting, the more you're gonna reach for that cigarette because you hate yourself and you're like, ew, I don't feel those, I hate myself. Instead, just be like, you know what? I love you so much. I'm so proud of you for me and you being able to observe this emotion. It's not ours, but we observed it and it's moving through. And you know, I'm gonna go smoke right now. I'm gonna go have a drink right now. I'm gonna go eat some cake right now. But then love yourself while you're doing it and say, you know, that's okay. I understand. You've been doing that your entire life. You've been doing that for 10 years, 15, 20 years. And it just feels comfortable for you. It's how you comfort yourself. You are a human being after all. Yes, you are a beautiful, benevolent, spiritual being, but you are also a human being. Okay? We forget that a lot. We think we're supposed to be flying high angels, perfect all the time. We're still in these 3D bodies and we're learning. It's a learning process. So give yourself love, show yourself compassion when you're in the motions and when you're feeling them, and show yourself compassion when you're using the crutches. Because like I always say, resistance creates persistence. Resisting that addiction, resisting those emotions that you need to feel, that addiction will keep persisting and those emotions will keep persisting, okay? Try to go a little bit longer each time. You know, it's something great you can do. Okay, I just woke up, I haven't eaten or drinking anything, no coffee. Instead of reaching for your phone, just sit there for 15 minutes and, okay, is anything coming up? How do I feel? And just observe and then reach for your phone. Sit with it 10 minutes. Like I said, just go a little bit longer each time, but show yourself love and compassion and understanding and realize how much of a badass you are for even attempting to do this, because most people spend their entire life running from emotions that they could have observed, moved through, and in turn raise their vibration, which would bring so much more benevolent abundance and love and success and happiness and joy and expansion in their life. So I'm proud of you for taking this on. Comment below if you have any suggestions on things that you do to incorporate your shadow, doing your own shadow work, what you do, how it's worked for you. If this video, if you liked it, if it resonated, hit that thumbs up button for me. Help your girl out. And, you know, subscribe if you haven't, so you can keep hearing me and my esoteric knowledge and my craziness and my little bit of a potty mouth. But you know what? I'm just being me. And I've spent my entire life trying to fit in and be someone else. And I'm fucking tired of it. I really am. I'm going to be myself so you can be yourself. Let's be ourselves. And yeah, hit the like button, subscribe, and I'll see you guys tomorrow.